Welcome to this session on integration with Git. In this session, we are going to see why should we use version control systems like Git. Let's get started. Let us take an example. We have Tom, Kim, and Henry working in a team and they want to work on the same project. So Tom creates a project and let us call this copy one of the project. He then gives this project to Kim. Kim makes some changes in the project and let us call this copy 2 of the project. Kim then hands this project to Henry and Henry adds his changes and let us call this copy 3 of the project. So now we have 3 copies of the project and now we have the challenge to merge all these changes and maintain a final copy. So one of the options can be Henry makes his changes and sends his project to Kim and now Kim merges her changes and sends the final project to Tom. Tom then merges his changes, reviews all the changes, and then maintains the final copy and distributes this copy to all the team members. Now, this is a very manual approach. It's time consuming, error prone, and then highly inefficient approach. So what to do now? There is another solution. They can use a common machine. So they will put a single copy of their project on a common machine. It can be a remote machine or on-premises machine, and then every one of the team member will log into this machine to work on the project. Now this approach has some other sets of challenges. Only one person can work at a time because we are now working on a single copy of the project. We are still not able to maintain any change history. We cannot revert to any earlier state of the project and then we have to maintain multiple copies per change of the project. So again, this approach is manual, inefficient, and time-consuming. So we are back with the same problem. What to do now? We need a solution which can manage all our changes and version controlling in an automated way. The answer is using a version control system like Git. Let us see what can we do with Git. So the team can put their project on a remote repository or any common location, and then every member in the team will install Git on their system. And then they can do a pull from the common repository. So they will get a local copy of the project and then they can work on their local copy. And then whenever they want, they can push it back to the remote repository and Git will take care of all the changes and version controlling. Let us look into more details. What exactly will be the steps? Let us say this is Tom's system, Kim's system, and Henry's local system. So the step one will be, all members will install Git on their system. So Tom will install Git, Kim, as well as Henry. And then step two is any one of them can put their project to a remote repository like Bitbucket or GitHub. And then step three will be everyone will clone this project from the remote repository. So they will do a Git clone and Tom will get a local copy of the project. Similarly, Kim will get a local copy and Henry. And now step four will be everyone can now work on their local copies. And the good thing about Git is while working on the local copies, they do not need to stay connected to the remote repository. Even they do not have the internet connection, they can still work on their local machines and network connection will be required only at the time of cloning, pulling or pushing of the project. So step five will be after they have done with their changes, they can push their changes back to the remote repository. So they will do a Git add, Git commit, and finally do a Git push and add their changes to the remote repository. And whenever they want, they can do a Git pull and they will get the latest changes on their local. So whatever changes others have done, they will get on their local system. So this is how Tom, Kim, and Henry do version controlling and resolve all their problems. Let us get started and apply these concepts in real time.